Hi. In our today's video, I would like to be talking about the mixture enrichment. Maybe you have that issue that everything is okay on your system, but out of some reason the ECU starts enriching the mixture. You set your duty cycle to 50% plus minus 5, and out of some reason the computer starts enriching the mixture. Why is it happening? And let's talk about it. One of the main culprits for this mixture enrichment can be the CTS, or the coolant temperature sensor. I posted that video about how to diagnose the coolant temperature sensor, how to see if it's good or bad. Here, I can post you a card here. But let's talk about it. Why? Why is it happening? As you know, I told you there to measure the resistance. And here I'm going to give you the table of the resistance that the coolant temperature sensor gives and how it works. You can see that on my Instagram page. I have it on the Facebook group Fix Your Mercedes. But here I'm going to post that table right now here. As you can see, as the temperature rises, the resistance falls. In this situation, if the coolant temperature sensor fails, then it is going to report the ECU that the mixture, that the engine in fact is cold, and the ECU is going to start enriching the mixture, and that is going to be happening all over again. How can we know how the coolant temperature sensor or the CTS looks like? Well, on some earlier generations, it has one pin. On the newer generations, it has two. And on the KE3.5, the generation starting from September 89, it has four. Well, let's see what's happening. This sensor has the task to report what it has to report both to the ignition module and the ECU. As it reports the ignition module about the temperature of the engine, the ignition module moves the timing in advance. As the ECL moves the timing in advance, the ECU has to be enriching the mixture. That's logical. And that happens that it is going to send then, I mean the ECU, the signal to the EHA to enriching the mixture. So if you have these problems, then check the CTS. Maybe that's your culprit. Either lambda or the CTS. Why do we need this sensor anyway? At first place, as the sensor has to report the temperature of the coolant, then the ECU knows if it has to activate the cold start valve or not, and whether to enriching the mixture or not, as I've said already. It functions this way. The CTS sends the signal to the fuel pump relay, and the fuel pump relay then activates the cold start valve. If you start your engine cold and up to 60 degrees C, from that point on, the cold start valve remains shut. It's, I want to say off. It's not operating anymore. Well, that's why the CTS has two contacts on the earlier versions. One of them has to go to the ECU, one of them to the ECL. Or at a four contact model, where there is a signal for the ECL, for the ECU, one of them is the ground, and the fourth contact. I'm gonna see and I'm gonna tell you then with a picture somewhere here. And that would be everything. So the point, the conclusion, if your ECU starts enriching the mixture, then you can suspect the coolant temperature sensor if it failed. And you know, I already said I'm gonna post the card to show you again how to check the CTS. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.